Anxiety is not just in your head, it's in your body, and specifically, it's triggered in your nervous system. Today, we're going to talk about how you can use heart rate variability as one way to get a numerical measure of how resilient your nervous system is, and how you can use HRV to actually train your nervous system to calm anxiety more efficiently. In the last video, we talked about biofeedback for anxiety. In this video, we're going to dive a little deeper into heart rate variability and how you can use it to improve anxiety, depression, chronic pain, and a bunch of other health concerns. You're going to learn what tools you can use to measure HRV, you'll learn about coherence or resonant frequency, and one specific skill that improves HRV and anxiety. So in this video, we're talking about heart rate variability, and just wanted to remind you all that I do have a free grounding skills course on my website. Go check it out if you want to learn more ways to calm your nervous system and get yourself settled when you have anxiety or trauma or depression or some other difficulty that you're facing. Okay, so when we talk about heart rate, it's a measure of your average beats per minute. So if your heart rate is 60 beats per minute, that means that on average, your heart is beating one beat per second. But over the course of 1 minute, your heart is going to speed up and slow down. Now, if you watched my previous video on biofeedback, you learned that when you breathe in, your heart beats faster, and when you breathe out slowly, your heart beats more slowly. That is heart rate variability. It's the measure of how much difference there is between your fast heartbeats and your slow ones. But HRV is much cooler than that. HRV is basically a measure of how good your nervous system is at adapting. It's a measure of its ability to switch between the parasympathetic and the sympathetic states. So a higher heart rate variability means that you're healthier, you're more resilient, and you're able to adapt to your circumstances and calm yourself down. Now, learning to improve your heart rate variability can help with anxiety, stress, and depression, and it can also help with getting into the flow and performing. It can help with chronic pain management, and it can help kids with belly aches, and it can help with overall gut health. Elite athletes use HRV to tell them when they're ready to do another hard workout, and high-performing professionals use it to manage stress. So why is heart rate variability so important? It all comes down to your nervous system. So your heart rate is determined by the autonomic nervous system. This is the subconscious part of your nervous system that handles 90% of your body's functioning. So this includes your stress response, your digestion, your immune system, and so much more. Now the autonomic nervous system has two main states, fight or flight and rest and digest. When your body senses a threat or a need to perform, it kicks on the sympathetic state, the fight, flight, freeze response. Stress chemicals like adrenaline and cortisol, these increase the heart rate and they send blood to the big muscles and they make you start sweating to cool down, which is why your hands get cold and clammy. This activated state is great in small doses and it helps you take action, get excited, and perform. But if you can't calm down, you get stuck in chronic stress, which is not great. This can lead to problems with your immune system, with your gut, your muscle tension, and overall it makes your body less healthy. But your body and your nervous system have a natural counterbalancing response. This is the parasympathetic response, the rest and digest response. You relax and your body heals and it digests food and it turns on your immune system. Your nervous system pumps out acetylcholine. This messages your heart to decrease how fast it's beating and it turns on peristalsis, which helps turn on your digestion. So a high HRV is essentially a numerical measure of how good you are at switching between the sympathetic and the parasympathetic state. Having a high HRV means that your body is healthy and adaptable. Your nervous system is healthy and it can turn on when needed and then relax when needed. High HRV can feel like a flow state where you're engaged and active and clear-headed. And controlled studies show that high HRV improves anxiety, depression, asthma, fibromyalgia, chronic pain, sleep, etc. So people with a high HRV are better at regulating their emotions, they're better at controlling their impulses, and they're better at processing information. But if your heart rate variability is constantly low, it means that your body is probably stuck in alert mode or stress mode. that your body is devoting all these resources, all this energy to performance instead of healing or the digestion or the immune system. Now, sometimes this is a good thing, right? Like if you're running a race, you want to stay in the sympathetic state the whole time. But if you're trying to relax and just can't, this is not great, right? This can lead to chronic stress or exhaustion. And trauma, PTSD, and chronic stress can all lead to a lower HRV, which makes sense because you're often stuck in this sympathetic, in this fight, flight, freeze state. Now, it is also possible to get stuck in the parasympathetic state or get stuck in freeze mode where you feel frozen or trapped or numb and you have a really hard time getting motivated or activated. Now, low HRV is associated with all kinds of physical problems, things like cancer, inflammation, blood pressure. It's connected to depression, chronic stress, pain, low emotional flexibility, anxiety, and quicker aging. Now, there are a lot of factors that impact your HRV. These are things like your age, your physical fitness, alcohol use, sleep, nutrition, stress, and genetics. But you can learn to improve your HRV using some really simple exercises. So let's talk about that. Okay, so HRV is used as a health marker and it generally decreases with age. It's also a measure of vagal tone, as we've talked about, right? Your vagus nerve helps you turn on that parasympathetic response, and you can basically train your vagal nerve to be stronger. There's a couple of ways to do this. Practicing mindfulness and meditation and yoga and breathwork are all ways to stimulate the vagus nerve. But heart rate variability gives you a way to see, to quantify the effectiveness of those techniques. You can see on a screen what's physically going on with your body. So thanks to this measure, researchers have been able to find out what aspect of these exercises is most effective. And while they all have various benefits, slow paced breathing is one of the most effective ways to improve your HRV. It's as simple as breathing at around 6 breaths per minute. So that means about 5 seconds to breathe in and 5 seconds to breathe out. Breathing at this slow rate can get you into a state of cardiac coherence. So cardiac coherence is when your body's systems take on a smooth, steady, synchronized wave. Now, normally your breathing, your heart rate, and your blood pressure, they all have an oscillation or a wave. Your breathing rate goes in and out. Your heart rate goes up and down. And your baroreflex, which is essentially your blood pressure, it also goes up and down. And when we're stressed, each of these systems is kind of doing its own thing. They're all going on and off at different times. But when you get into cardiac coherence, your heart rate, respiratory rate, and blood pressure, they all sync up and they smoothly interact with each other. When they get in sync, this is called the resonance frequency. And when you get into this resonant frequency, you're basically telling your body, you're safe, you can calm down. And it tells your nervous system to turn on that rest and digest response. Now, the easiest way to achieve this is through resonance frequency breathing, which is basically slowing down your breathing to match your heart rate. And you can feel it when your body feels calmer, feels more centered and more settled. Just writing this video reminded me to breathe more slowly, which helped me get settled over and over again. Now, this can get really technical, and if you want to learn more, definitely check out the work by Dr. Givertz. He has put years of study into this. Here's an image from one of his publications showing how the breathing and the heart rate get into sync. And you can see the heart rate changing in this sine wave pattern and the breathing syncing up with it, and everything just kind of smooths out. This is good, right? This is what we want to go for. It's good for your body and it's good for your mind. Okay, so let's talk about how to check your HRV. The easiest way to check your heart rate variability is to buy a Bluetooth heart rate monitor, and then you can use the free app Elite HRV. Now, you can also kind of measure your HRV with an Apple Watch, but it isn't that accurate and it's not that responsive. But it might be able to give you an idea of your HRV without buying something new. So I'll link to an article in the description below if you want to learn how to set that up. But if you'd like to actively learn, you know, how to improve your HRV and to reach that resonant frequency, the most accessible way is through a program like HeartMath or Flowly. Flowly is a VR system with a heart rate monitor, and it walks you through the process of finding your resonant frequency. This app was funded by a grant from the NIH, and it gradually teaches you how to soothe your nervous system by giving you feedback on what your state is. And as you get into a flow state, the scenery changes around you, and you know, it encourages you to keep going. Now, Flowly is not a sponsor, but they did send me the equipment for free, and I really like what they're doing, so that's one of the reasons I'm, you know, mentioning their work in this video. So to summarize all of this, you can learn to turn on your parasympathetic response. You can learn to train yourself to resolve stress and to strengthen your vagal tone. And this can have wide-ranging positive impacts, anywhere from lowering anxiety to improving depression and lots of other physical health benefits. One of the best things about HRV is that for the logical, you know, quantitative-minded soul, it gives you this concrete measurement of how you're doing. It gives you graphs and charts and a visual for how you're doing instead of this fuzzy idea, you know, meditation is good for you, right? So if you'd like to try resonant frequency breathing or learn more about your HRV, then check out some of the resources in the description. And as always, thank you for being here. I love my audience, all of you people who are trying to learn new things and improve your lives. So keep up the good work. And I will see you next week for part 3 of this series on how you can manage chronic pain using heart rate variability and resonant frequency breathing and biofeedback. We'll be talking with the creator of Flowly. So she has done research on this topic for over half a decade. So excited for that. Look forward to seeing you then. Thank you for watching and take care.